Good morning. Thank you for joining us on what we believe is a really exciting day for REISA and the beginning of what we think is going to be a fantastic partnership with another great South Australian organisation, PointData. This morning is about a few things. Many of you will have seen, read, heard me talk about our strategic plan and how we're forging REISA back as the peak body for real estate in South Australia. I'm going to introduce Ben in a minute, and Ben's going to take you through some high level. I think it's really important. You guys are the first people to get your hands on this report this morning. So this hasn't gone anywhere, hasn't gone to media, hasn't gone to government. Because you came today, you get your hands on it first. So I will not steal Ben's thunder anymore, but Ben gave me his title before, Head of Planning and Delivery. Ben is from PointData. He's been, I won't speak too much more, but PointData has been amazing to work with. All of you have been phenomenal. You've made us look very good. You've made me look very good. There's a photo of me in there too. So thank you. And we're really, really, really excited about bringing a new lens and a new voice to the market. So over to you, Ben.
So I'll just quickly go through some of the key viewpoints within the report. I won't dive into it too much. It is a good read, so I do implore you to kind of flick through and have a really good read and absorb some of the key things in there. So one of the key things that we put in here is the median sale price and average daily sales. This is a fascinating graph for basically historically looking back at what has happened over the COVID period. You guys lived that experience, you know exactly how it went, but to look back on some of the key patterns or trends or the move away from trends is really fascinating. One of the bar graphs which we put into this report is a breakdown of those micro market indices that Kane mentioned before. So what we can see here in this graph illustrates the proportion of properties that grew or declined in value. And this black line here represents the percentage of properties that were going down and those that were going up. In the COVID period, we actually had to add a new graph to this, which was 10% plus growth. And you can see it was just enormous growth. In one period, we had 88% of areas in metropolitan Adelaide going up over a 6 month period by 10% or more. Phenomenal growth. Back in 2019, we had 50% of properties that were going down and 50% that were going up. And there wasn't talk about an impending boom or a bust, it was just a steady, stable market. And that's probably what we're going to be heading to going forward. So that's a little bit of a snapshot of some of the key data points which we provide. You'll also see in the report, we give a 3 month map which maps all of these. So which areas are going up and which areas are going down. You'll visually be able to see that in the publication. And one last slide before I let you mingle about the housing affordability that Kane mentioned as well. It's a really important thing, not just as an industry, but for the health of a city and a state as well. And I suppose what we wanted to demonstrate in these maps and in this publication is that there's still a lot of really good affordable housing opportunities for the people of South Australia. Just to reiterate, really excited about the partnership with REISA moving forward and working with you all in the industry. So thank you.